Well, g'day, g'day, it's Tim Buchalka, the Aussie Android Dev Guy, and in today's video, we're going to cover installing and configuring Android Studio on a Linux machine. Now, if you're running a Mac or you're running a Windows machine, refer to the links to my left where I go through and show you how to do what we're doing in this video for your platform. Now, the other thing you'll need, the prerequisite for this, is you need to have the Java development kit installed on your machine. Now, if you haven't got that installed, you're not sure if you've got it installed, or you don't even know what the Java development kit is, click on this video to my left again and you'll be taken to a video where I go through the steps required, and then you can come back to this video after and do the installation. So let's now proceed with installing Android Studio on a Linux box. So let's go ahead and install Android Studio on a Linux machine. So I'll boot it up. I'm going to click on my browser. I'll go into my browser and I'm going to go to developer.android.com. You can see it's on the screen there. I'm going to scroll down and click on Get SDK or Get the SDK. And click on Download Android Studio. Make sure you don't click on the SDK tools only. We need to scroll down further and select Linux down here. So I'm going to click on that one because the tools are obviously only the tools and not the graphical user interface. And of course, we want the graphical user interface. I'm going to save that file. Okay, we're just about done. I'm going to go over to the file and I'm going to unzip it, double click it, and I scroll over to here and I'm just going to unpack it. I'm going to extract it. Now I'm going to put it in my home folder because it's going to create a directory automatically. You can obviously put it, /opt or something like that. But in my case, I'm just going to put it in the home folder. Click on extract, close, and we're done with the installation, or with the extract at least. I'm going to close down that. I'm going to go to my terminal. And I'm going to go into that folder. So I'm going to go back to my home folder. If I do an ls now, you should be able to see Android Studio. So there's Android Studio. Go into that folder. Have another look. There's also a folder called bin, so I'm going to cd into that folder, and we should have a file there called studio.sh. you can see that in green in the right hand side of the screen. So I can type ./studio.sh and press enter, and that should start up for us. That's starting up Android Studio. Now it's fetching the SDK to figure out what it needs to download, because of course we've only installed Android Studio. Now the option here that's come up is Android Virtual Device. I'm not going to click that now, but you'd normally want that because that's the emulator that enables you to run Android apps on your Linux machine. But to save some time, I'm going to click that off, and we'll talk about that a little bit later in the video. And note also the Android SDK location. You may need that later. It's automatically gone to, and then for my home folder, /android/SDK. And click on next. And you can see the wizard's come up and detected that the Android emulator can run in an accelerated performance mode. So you do want to check those instructions. So click on those if you're not sure how to check that your KVM is enabled for faster speed. In this case, ours is, so that's good. So we can click on next. I'm going to just make sure that's highlighted, the Android SDK license, and click on accept to accept all the licenses. And we're going to click on finish. Now that's going to go ahead and download everything it needs. This is the SDK now, you know, the version of the Lollipop and the support files and tools and so forth. So I'm going to pause the video till it's just about done. Okay, we're just about finished, as you can see now. So we'll just wait for this to finish off. Okay, we're all done and everything's been downloaded and installed. Click on finish. So we now reach this screen. So what I want to do is just show you a few configuration options. Firstly, click on configure and go down to project defaults and click on project structure. Now I just want to show you, that's again how to find where the Android SDK location is. You may need to know that. And also the JDK location. You can see this is where it's automatically found by Android Studio, the Java SDK that we installed in a previous video. So if by chance you're having some problems, this is where you'd update that to point to the relevant Java development kit. But in this case, we've got Java 8 and we're good to go. So I'm going to click on cancel to get out of that. I'm just going to go back. I also want to show you SDK Manager. And click on that. We'll also address the update that was on the right-hand corner of the screen as well shortly. Now this is where you can get updates to the SDK. Now this is where Google on a regular basis will issue fixes and new versions of build tools, SDK tools, those types of things. This is how you find out whether they're updated or not. Now you'll get a status of whether it's up to date. Installed means you've got the latest version. If it comes up and obviously says update, it means there is an update, and you would click on the checkbox and then come over to here to install, and that would install the update for you. So it's good to come in here periodically just to check and see what's been updated. But just going down a little bit, we're in Android 5.01, API 21. That's the latest version as of the time I'm shooting this video of Android. So this is what we're dealing with. Now you can see these check marks have been put on automatically by Google because it wants you to download them. I'm going to click on deselect all. And what I suggest you have installed is the documentation. You can see it hasn't been installed. I would recommend that for sure, because it's good to have that documentation on your machine. You know, anytime you're looking up how, you know, particular parameters for methods, you know, those types of things, an API structure and so forth, it's great having the documentation. Now, if you want Android TV functionality, you'd click on those images. I'm not going to select those or Android Wear. But these ones down here are the ones you'll probably want to use. Now, the ARM EIBI is a slower system image, but it's got more compatibility. So if you've got less than 4 or even 6 gigabytes of RAM, you may only be able to run this one. If that's the case, select that. But if you've got a beefier system and a decent graphics card, select the Intel x86 Atom system image. Now, incidentally, you might be looking here and looking at _64 and thinking, oh, I've got a 64-bit CPU, maybe I'll run that one. That's not what it means. That's actually a 64-bit image of Android. So it's the Android emulator for the 64-bit edition of Android. So you probably won't need to use that in a lot of testing. So I suggest you just stick to this one here, the Android x86. But if you do have any difficulties running x86, you know, if you find that your system hasn't got the performance you thought it had, you can always come back into here and select ARM instead and then select that. And the other thing I suggest you have also is the sources. It's already installed, as you can see, but it's great having the sources for the Android Software Development Kit. So you can actually look at the code created by the other developers, the people who've developed Android. And it's just really interesting going through and getting some great ideas. Lastly, I also want to talk to you about the platforms. You can see that the SDK platform has been installed, but Google APIs is the Google specific platform. So I also suggest you would normally click on and select that as well. And that's things like Google Maps and so forth, the APIs for that as well. So if you're going to be using apps that are using that, or you want to emulate those, so if you're going to be writing apps that use the Google specific APIs, like as I mentioned, Google Maps, you'll want that selected as well. Okay, then scrolling down to the bottom, there may be some other things you need here. You've got some things installed. The Android support repository and Google repository are installed by default. But things like the Google Play services, if you're going to be having leaderboards and achievements, like for games, you want that. And some of these other things, depending on whether you've got that functionality, you may want that installed. It doesn't hurt if you've got plenty of hard drive space and plenty of download capability on your internet connection just to select everything if you want to. And obviously the other things here aren't compatible with Linux, so we don't need to address those. So once you'd selected everything you wanted, you just click over into install and it would install that, download and install that for you automatically. I won't do that here in the interests of time. I'm going to close that down. So lastly, I've talked about addressing this update. I just want to show you another way to get to that. But you can go back into settings. And if you scroll down to the bottom, there's an option here for updates. This is where you specify the updates that you can actually choose. You've got a couple of options here. You've got stable channel, beta, dev, and canary. Now, these are the various versions in terms of how stable they are. So the canary channel hasn't really undergone much testing at all. It's really just the developers pumping out a fix. And going up from bottom to top, they're more stable. So the stable obviously is the most stable edition that you can sort of find of the Android Studio. I normally set mine to beta channel. That's sort of one step down, and you're still getting a lot of updates that are more relevant, but you're not getting a lot of bugs. Because bearing in mind, if you know much about Google, they have forever got having products in beta for a long period of time. So I trust them at that level. So it's up to you, but I would choose beta myself if given a choice. So I'm going to select that now and click on OK. And again, you saw this update over here. To actually go ahead and update, it's pretty straightforward. You can see here it's got these are the versions. I'm going to click on update and restart. And you can notice that it's actually a patch that it's downloading. It's not downloading the whole package again. So it's done in a very efficient manner. And you can see that was very quick. It updated it very quickly. Now, you might be wondering, why is this coming up with another update? And that's because, you remember, I selected and changed it to the beta version. And the previous update, when I clicked it, was for the stable version. So if I click on update now, you can see now it's looking for a new Android Studio 1.1 release candidate one is available. But I won't do that now because you've seen how to do those updates. Now lastly, the last thing I suggest you do is just click on and create a new test project just to make sure everything's working. So on this screen, you can choose the application name, your company domain. Now if your company name was timberchalker.com, you notice as I'm typing down the bottom, the package name is being reversed. So it's a combination of the reversed company name and the name of the app. So Android Studio does that for you automatically, but we'll talk more about package names in a future video. But clicking on next. And I'm just going to click on and leave all the options as their defaults. Next. Finish. And that should open up this package. You can see it's working away in the background. You can see it's chugging there down the bottom of the screen. It's just indexing and setting up. The first time you do create a new project in Android Studio, it does take some time to get going. It has to download various bits and pieces and index them and sort of compile them. So we'll wait till that finishes. I'll just pause the video. And that's it. That's the little sample test application. So at this point, we're actually done. And that's a wrap. We've now gone ahead and installed and configured Android Studio, and we're up and going, and you're ready to start creating some Android apps. Please subscribe to my channel. Click on the subscribe button to the left over there and be kept up to date with videos as I'm coming out and releasing them on a regular basis for all things Android. Please also check out my Android Lollipop course. Over 11,000 or close to 11,000 students have already taken it up. 25 hours plus of video training there, teaching you how to become a great Android app developer. Now, speaking of content, please also get back to me. Let me know what you thought of this video, but also what you'd like me to cover in future videos, because I'm here to create a great channel for Android app development. So I need to know some of the things that you're stuck with, that you'd like me to cover, that you'd like to see in future videos, and I'll do my best to address those. Lastly, check out some of the videos down the bottom left hand there, up to my left and sort of down a little bit, and you'll see that there's videos there that you can click to get to find more Android app goodness. Okay, so this is Tim Buchalka, the Aussie Android Dev Guy, signing out, and I'll see you in, wait for it, the next video. Cheers for now.